Yeah, protest! Woohoo! We'll be out of here by halftime, right, guys? Ugh! Shouldn't we have been arrested by now? It's been a really long time. I'm watching Matt Barkley and Sam Bradford in a duel for the ages. Is that a beer? Can I have that? Yeah. Oh, Garner! Hello, and welcome to Garbage Time, presented by Geico. I am your host, Kate Nolan. Tonight on the show, Bob Costas tries to rap, everyone on The Bachelor tries to do sex, and Dan Soder tries to make fun of me, and it doesn't work, so screw you, Dan Soder. But first, guys, Happy New Year.
Yeah.
I hope you all spent the first night of 2017 doing something awesome and fun that you love to do. I did the same thing I do every year. I was in my PJs, I ordered Chinese food, and I watched the Twilight Zone marathon. I love that. That show is so good. It's so ahead of its time, and it influenced so much stuff we love today. Kids, think of it as like Black Mirror, but for old people. The only downside to watching the marathon is that now, like, I want to talk about Twilight Zone for hours. Like, I just want to do the show on Twilight Zone, but this is a sports show, and so I can't. Sorry, we should probably talk about sports. Okay, so we've reached the playoffs in the NFL. Hard to believe we're here already. I feel like the season just started. But it's been kind of a crazy season, hasn't it? Like, lots of weird, unexpected stuff happened. Like, Buffalo. For a second there, it looked like this was finally going to be the year they turned it around. Like a drunk woman at a tailgate. But then no, they couldn't pull it off. Unlike the pants of a drunk woman at a tailgate. But hey, Tyrod had a couple games there where he looked pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah, seriously, that guy agrees. Look, I'm sure somewhere in this clip of this season-long highlight video that the Bills released last week, I'm sure we can see something Grady did. Well, I don't see him there. Maybe let's fast forward a little bit. Yeah, still not seeing any Tyrod. No Tyrod there. No, that's shady. Wait, he isn't in there at all? Not once? Huh. Did the Bills have a quarterback this season? Maybe Tyrod never existed in the first place. But Buffalo fans just got so drunk that then even we started to hallucinate, and what we thought was the quarterback was just a dildo that somebody threw on the field. And sorry, I've been watching too much Twilight Zone. The Jets also didn't make it to the postseason. That's not weird, but what is pretty weird is that on Monday, their owner, Woody Johnson, mysteriously tweeted and then deleted the words, Bob Kraft. Just Bob Kraft. Was he trying to Google him? Or, you know, search his name on Twitter? Trying to reply to a tweet that asked, who's your daddy? And maybe. Or maybe he's sending a signal to his home planet to let them know who to abduct next. Think about it. If you were an alien and your boss alien was like, you're a human now, pick a name, would you not pick Woody Johnson? It's penis. I'm actually amazed we bought it that he was a human for this long. It doesn't even make any sense. I'm sorry, I did it again, didn't I? The Texans! The Texans somehow made it to the postseason, and now they're gonna have to start Brock Osweiler, even after he got savaged just a few weeks ago. Sorry, Texans fans, I just don't think they're gonna stay alive for very long. Unless the Texans have been dead the whole time. Let's look at the Texas team that does deserve to be in the playoffs, Dallas. Between Dak and Zeke, their rookies are crushing it. But then last week, Tony Romo comes back for one drive, gets a touchdown, and now everyone's all high on Romo again. It's almost like Romo is the ghost of football past. And he pretends he's out of the way, but he keeps hovering over Dak as a constant reminder that no matter what he does, he'll never be a legend. And that's why when Dez threw a touchdown this season, he made sure to do it left-handed out of respect for ghosty Romo, because no one else is supposed to throw a touchdown with their right hand. I'm sorry, guys. This is getting so, it's really embarrassing. But hey, here's a crazy stat. Dez was the only person to throw a left-handed touchdown in the NFL this season.
What?
Another crazy stat. Matt Ryan led the Falcons to the playoffs by throwing touchdown passes to 13 different receivers in 2016, which is the most in a single season in NFL history. Julio Jones, Taylor Gabriel, Mohamed Sanu, Justin Hardy, Tevin Coleman, Jacob Tammy, Austin Hooper, Devontae Freeman, Aldrick Robinson, Levine Toilolo, Patrick DeMarco, Joshua Perkins, and DJ Televia. How do you even have that many pass catchers? Is that even allowed? Like, where are you finding these people? Come to think of it, the Falcons got in trouble a few seasons ago for pumping fake crowd noise into their stadium, so clearly they have a machine that can do that. What if they also built a machine that can clone receivers? It sounds crazy, right? Until you remember the name of the employee who was fired for that crowd noise controversy.
Roddy White, not that Roddy White, but the Roddy White who is in charge of game day operations.
Yeah, thanks for clearing up that name confusion. Not that Roddy White, indeed.
Come on! Two Roddy Whites? In the world, even? Not even just the same organization. Am I really the crazy one here? Am I? I am. Okay, you guys, you're right. I'm sorry. To be honest, if I'm honest with you, I probably watched a little too much Twilight Zone this weekend, and clearly I need to recalibrate because I am overthinking everything. No one actually thinks this season in the NFL has been like the Twilight Zone.
I thought I was in the Twilight Zone a few times.
Wait, Khalil Mack thinks the same thing? Maybe I'm not crazy. And you know what, come to think of it, the Raiders did make it to the playoffs for the first time in a while, and then Derek Carr got hurt in week 16, and then Backy McQuarterback got hurt in week 17, and now they have to make a playoff run with Connor Cook, if that's even his real name. It's almost as if, like, an external force, something more powerful than we could ever imagine, jinxed the team's only hope before the season even started. Prediction number 6, Derek Carr is gonna be dope this year. Oh my God. It was me. I was the monster the whole time. No, that can't be right. I'm a good person. I swear it. I'm not a monster!
We live in fear of the unfamiliar things around us. Strangers, aliens, monsters, Roddy White. But what if the true horror is somewhere much closer indeed? Inside us all, in our dark and unexamined depths. Look if you dare, for you just might find the Twilight Zone.
Welcome back to Garbage Time, guys. It's our first show of 2017, and we thought there's no better way to kick things off than with one of our best friends, comedian Dan Soder. Conveniently for us, he said he'd come in right before his beloved San Francisco 49ers decided to relieve themselves of their head coach and GM and light their dumpster of a franchise completely on fire. And since I am, of course, a super nice person, I went for the kill and kicked him while he was down. Love you, Dan. Hello.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm okay. What are you up to?
Billions is coming out in February.
That's very exciting.
49ers fired Trent Baalke and Chip Kelly.
Sure did.
Oh, God.
How do we feel about that?
Oh, it's like a family member getting rid of an abusive boyfriend. You're like, good for you. Jed Yorks is listening to Beyonce's Lemonade, and he's like, I'm done with them. I'm done with both of them.
I'm sorry.
I'm not sorry.
I'm sorry.
Trent, we should have got Dak. You're gone.
Boy,
Chip,
bye.
Sweater vest. Bye. Yeah.
So you're happy.
Oh, my God.
You're not worried that Jed York is an idiot.
I can't look at a picture of him because he just reminds me of a boy king. Does that make any sense?
And his name's Jed, which fits.
Yeah,
King Jed.
Like, King Jed? The serfs don't have anything to eat. He's like, well, I have everything to eat. It's just that. I don't like him.
Yeah.
I only come when the 49ers are in the darkest of hours.
I know.
I'm like, Katie, help me. What's it like being
it's
a Patriots
really
fan?
Really great.
Is
it's
it?
Great.
Or
it
does it completely lack all emotion and connection to
No,
your
it's great.
I think the real way the Niners have to solve it is by copying what the Broncos did and create like a president of football operations and then hire like a Mike Shanahan, Mike Holmgren, I'm fine with that, and have him pick the GM and the head coach and run it like that. and then the boy king can just sit in his palace.
Like, make the big men fight for me.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Just like what this earlier this week, and he's like, you can't fire the owner. You can't get rid of
it. Oh, God, that
you can't
so
fire
mad.
The boy king.
It's my ball. I'm going to go home.
I own it, so you can't have Josh McDaniels. I just wanted to.
Oh, please. I do not want what? Josh. You want to talk about boy king? He's Joffrey. Josh McDaniels.
You think he's more Joffrey than boy king? Jed York is the first king
that's
I thought
the argument.
Of.
Jed York is the worst. I'm going to play this back when we return to glory, and I'll be like, what a long road.
I'll be dead. So.
Yeah, okay.
The 49ers are too easy to make fun of. I'm going to stop making fun of them. They're probably the easiest team in the NFL to make fun of.
Patriots are pretty easy to make fun of.
No, that's not. They win, so you can't really make fun of us. We don't feel it. So.
That's your logic. Just because you win, they're not easy to make fun of.
Yes. Okay, I think we should settle this. We should figure out whose team is easier to make fun of.
Done.
It's time for our first ever edition of FanStuhl. Are you ready?
Don't try to serious face me. I saw you getting a character.
Are you ready? I asked.
Yes, I am ready.
Your mascot is named Sourdough Sam.
It's great bread.
It's bread.
You play in a stadium named after a razor blade.
Sharp and new and shiny.
Not really.
Yours is named after pants.
How so?
Levi Stadium.
Yeah, cool. You know what has denim's done for this country over Gillette? You cut people's faces on the reg. We keep legs warm, cowboys looking cool as shit. Just put a lighthouse on your stadium.
Ah, this'll dock the boats, huh? Just in case they come up on the harbor.
Yeah, you got wins, but you have no common sense.
You're closer to San Jose than you are to San Francisco.
Oh, cool. Kind of like how the New York Giants and the New York Jets play in East Rutherford, New Jersey. So there goes that theory.
Swiss cheese!
At least they have the ability to share a stadium. The Raiders would rather go to Vegas than share a stadium.
Yeah, because you want to talk. Have you seen their owner's haircut? Of course he wants to go to Vegas. He always looks like he's trying to see his first boob. Yeah, what's up?
The last time you won a Super Bowl, mm-hmm. Creep by TLC was the number one song in the United States.
What a great song.
Mm.
You guys are winning at the end of the world, which shows that you're evil, because that's why the world's ending. We're the good guys. The Niners were never the bad guys. How does that feel that you've, since 2001, primarily just been the bad guys?
Dope.
Oh, yeah, it's a dope.
Christian Ponder's on your team.
Yeah, cool. That guy's awesome. He can run and throw. That's so neat. You have Tom Brady. He's almost done. Yeah. Oh, you don't even have to react. I just
my inner voice.
Yeah, you're like, oh. Eli Manning is your kryptonite.
Name a good quarterback you've had after Steve Young.
This hurts. Tim Rattay. I wanted to say Sean Hill, but then we just have to end the show because everybody would be laughing. I feel like you're really bringing a lot of Belichick attitude into this, and I'm really like having like a lot of Bill Walsh, George Seifert, like fun but constructive, and then you're doing like mean.
It's really hard to not laugh when you talk, and so in order for me to get into a headspace where I'm not gonna laugh, I have to be a total super bitch.
Awesome. Well, I'm a comedian, and that's how I pay my rent.
Great.
So this is good. But as someone who also hates conflict, this is tough.
This is really hard.
Because there's part of me that I'm like, this is a game, and then I'm like, hey, for real though, Kenny, like, you pissed at me, right? And this is why the Patriots are better than the 49ers. I see the error of my ways. Someone remove my heart. I want to go to the playoffs.
Now the lights are on. I can safely say thank you for coming. It was great to have you here.
Thank you for interrogating me and making me feel bad about an already tough season.
You're welcome. Sorry your team sucks, but I'm not really that sorry.
When they go low, we go high. Good
that
luck to the
out.
Patriots
yeah.
in the playoffs.
As always, when Dan Soder comes by, there's a lot more where that came from, so be sure to listen to the Garbage Time podcast this week. And also, season 2 of Billions is back on Showtime in February. Watch it. That guy's amazing. Coming up, I'm going to go see Nick, and I'm going to have sex with him. It's just going to be magical. My heart is gold, but my vagine is platinum. Welcome back to Garbage Time, guys. It's Anymore. It makes me sad there's no more Thursday night football. First up, I'm gonna add Katie Nolan. Yep, that's right, because while you guys were all sitting around all holiday break getting presents, I was busy getting buckets and leading Yorkville High School girls basketball to the Ottawa Championship. Yep, how good was I? Well, why not ask my coach, Kim Wences? Katie was the tournament MVP, and it was very well deserving. She does so much for us. She's just unstoppable.
Yeah.
Not really me, but my coach did say something very similar in high school. Katie is unstartable. Almost the same. Speaking of TV legends, I'm going to drop Bob Costas, who we found out during the Winter Classic is apparently one of the lost members of the St. Lunatics.
Nelly's signature tune is "It's Getting Hot in Here," and maybe you know what the next line is. So to paraphrase, even though it's not really getting hot in here, if it's getting hot in here, then take off all your pads. Here's Nelly.
Bob, it's a cold outdoor game. You're quoting "hot in." Next up, I'm gonna add equipment managers. Big week for equipment managers, specifically the Carolina Hurricanes equipment manager, George Alves, who had to dress up as emergency backup goalie on Saturday against the Lightning. And he played. George got in for the last 8 seconds of the game, which is really cool, but it was probably a good thing that there were absolutely no shots on net.
I just remember looking down the ice and seeing the puck in the corner and saying, stay in that corner.
What an important story, you know, finally, 2017, this is the year that finally men who are equipment managers will get to play professional sports. It's like we've been waiting for so long. I'm going to drop marching bands because right before that awesome Rose Bowl on Monday, the USC marching band's official drum major did a routine and came insanely close to stabbing himself in the foot with a knife. Look at that. Hey, I shouldn't have to tell you this, Trojan, but be safer. Hey, speaking of bowls of roses, The Bachelor is back.
Yes.
Yeah, one guy pumped. But after that first episode, I'm going to add Corinne, who might already be my favorite for the season because I love chaos. She's 24 years old. She has a nanny who feeds her cucumbers. And as she keeps reminding us, she runs a multi-million dollar business that she got from daddy, but that all pales in comparison to this.
So tonight, I'm gonna go see Nick, and I'm going to have sex with him. It's just gonna be magical.
My heart is gold, but my vagine is platinum.
My vagine is titanium. God, I'm so sorry for that. And I'm gonna drop Josephine. I'm sorry, Josephine. I am all for making a first impression, but a hot dog?
I just wanted to let you know that you're a wiener in my book.
Okay, wow. Is that real? I hope it's.
Do you wanna like Lady and the Trumpet?
They're super not delicious.
That goes down pretty hard.
It's rough on the.
I know, I too was shocked when she opened the book and we saw it wasn't a real book. That's it for Ad Drop. Coming up, I sing all the Mariah Carey songs that she didn't sing and I save New Year's. Yay me, we'll be right back. Welcome back to Garbage Time, guys. Run out of time in the show, but there's some stuff we didn't cover, so before we go, some quick shout-outs. Shout-out to Stephen A. Smith, who said Brett Favre is trying to jinx Aaron Rodgers by saying the Packers will win the Super Bowl, which beat out his second-best theory that Brett Favre likes the Packers. Shout-out to Mariah Carey, who bombed her New Year's Eve performance by lip-syncing and not even singing along to some songs. But in case you missed that train wreck, you can always catch Raiders-Texans on Saturday. Shout-out to Eli Manning, who said he was disappointed in his wide receivers partying in Miami, but only because they didn't appear to pack shirts. So add shade to the list of things Eli can't throw. And shout-out to our Garbage Time Hero of the Week. This week, it's this guy. Spoiler alert, bro. You're gonna gonna die anyway. He's a dinosaur. That's all for this week, guys. Next week on Garbage Time, Michael Crabtree gets a new necklace. Lane Kiffin gets fired again. And hey, Rob Ryan, you got some time on your hands now, huh? What's up? Huge thanks to Dan Soder for coming by and to you all for watching. Have a great week, guys. Here's more garbage. He's not gonna die like a person. They're just extinct and he's working out and it's all for nothing. Someone should tell him. If I was gonna die, I'd want someone to be like, stop working out. You're wasting your time.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Yeah.
And I love ASMR. What is Jim Tomsula doing now, do you think?
Eating a sandwich and breathing through his nose heavily.
The cheese.
He's like, can I get a napkin? That's, I bet he's recently, in the past 10 minutes, he's asked for a napkin.
Passing record, schmassing record. You're no Tom Brady. Why am I laughing? Patriots, you can't make fun of the Patriots. It's too hard. We're too good.
All your tiny little white receivers that are like,
I got 5 yards, I got 6 yards. Move the ball.
It's like Brady's Willy Wonka, and they're all the Oompa Loompas. They're like, Oompa, Oompa, first down, go. How great would it be if Eli Manning beat him?
No, I can't entertain that idea.
With his furrowed brow. So mm-hmm. I guess it's fun.
Eli is like the little brother that is objectively worse than his older brother, but somehow always like gets the game-winning goal, and the older brother is like, kidding
yeah,
me.
He does the trick shot at the carnival that goes in every time. And like Eli's like, I just think about it like I'm throwing laundry into a basket.
And Payne's like, I've been here for a week doing nothing but this. Oh, now I'm arrested? That's what it takes?